Hello dear participant, let us see the ninth compound in the series of structural elucidation. The mass spectra is this. The molecular weight of the compound is 101, and if you apply rule of 13, that comes around C7H16, right? If you see the nitrogen rule, then the mass is odd number, and therefore there may be odd number of nitrogen. Okay, base peak is at 72, and there is no isotopic peak, and the peak I took is this peak and this peak. These two peaks are almost equal, both of them are equal. And therefore, we consider it is M minus 29 peak and M minus 71 peak. And if you take IR, zone 1 is present. This region is zone 1, and zone 1 region is alcoholic OH, amine or amide NH or CH of alkyne. And if you see the peak, CH of alkyne will be sharp, and it is not sharp, and therefore it is not possible. And OH will be a banana like shape, it will be more intense, but it is a medium intensity and medium broadness. That is a peculiar peak for NH stretching, and therefore amine is present. Okay, and if it is amide, there will be a carbonyl stretching in zone 4, and it is not absent. If you see zone 2, there is a peak, there are several peaks which are just below 3000, and it says it is sp3ch. Zone 3 is absent, zone 4 is absent, NH is present, and therefore it is not amide, it is a amine. If it is amide, then we could have another carbonyl stretching. Okay, carbonyl stretching is absent, and therefore it is amine. Let us see whether it is primary or tertiary or secondary amine. Let us see. In carbon 13 NMR, we have three set of protons, carbons, but we have seen in mass spectra there are C7 carbon. If you minus nitrogen from here, that we have to reduce two hydrogen and one carbon, and that to C6, at least you will have C6. But in if you see C13 NMR, but it has only three types of carbons, and therefore the six carbons are present as a set. We have to see whether 2 2 2 2 or 2 3 1. We have to see all the six carbons are present as a two set, three sets. And if you notice, there is a deshielded proton. This carbon is deshielded. That means this carbon must be connected to amine group. Okay, let us see which is that. In proton NMR, we can see there are four signals, but the one signal is due to amine signal. If you see the number of integral in the amine signal, that is exchanges with the D2O, and it is singlet, this indicates this is the proton present in amine. And if you see the integral value, it is 1. In molecular formula, we have seen 16. Around here in 16, if you reduce CH, then it will be 15, right? 6 plus 4, 10, 15 totally, and therefore only one hydrogen is there. If there is only one hydrogen, then we can say it is NH, and that must be a secondary amine. Okay, that is the conclusion. In secondary amine, it has a 2R group on both sides, and what we can imagine is there are 6 carbon, but only three signals in the carbons, and therefore all the six carbons are present as three sets. And I would say it is identically in both side of the amine group. Let us analyze one by one. Four types of protons are there, and three types of carbon, and one type without carbon. That means it is amine. Especially it is NH, because there is only one proton in that signal. The integral value says that there is only one proton, and therefore it is secondary amine. If you analyze the first signal A, take this signal, it is at 0.9 ppm, that means it is free from any other electronegative element and therefore it is far away from amine group. Okay. And it is a triplet, that means it must have a CH2 group adjacent to that, since it is a triplet. And the integral value says it, there is a 6 hydrogen. And if there are 6 identical hydrogen, then we have to consider CH3 2, 2 times. There is no CH6 and there is no such compound, and therefore we have to consider 2 CH3 group which are identical. And then we can say the 2 CH3 groups are on either side of this amine, secondary amine, which must be symmetrical. If it is symmetrical only, then we can consider that 2 CH3 group would be identical. If it is unsymmetrical, we cannot expect an identical CH3 group. And therefore, and that too it is not connected to nitrogen. And therefore, there must be some other group which is connected to nitrogen, and the CH3 group is far away from nitrogen. This is what we can infer from the spectra. And if you see the second signal B, and it is at 1.5 pm. Therefore, that too not directly connected, but it is somewhat closer than this. And therefore, this CH2, we can consider this CH2. This is also not connected to amine, but it is closer than this. And therefore, we can say there is a CH3, CH2 group. And it is a sextet, that means it splits into 6. And therefore, there must be 5 hydrogen. 5 hydrogen will split the signal into 6. And 5 hydrogen means here one side it is CH3, another side is CH2. Let us see that also. If you see the signal 1 that we know, we have already discussed, it is amine NH signal, since there is only one proton, it is secondary amine, all those things we know, already we discussed. And if you see the signal D, there is a 2.5 ppm, it is typically which is connected to amine, and therefore, and it is a triplet, and therefore it is adjacent, there are 2 hydrogen adjacent, and the integral value is 4, and therefore there must be 2 CH2 group. There must be 2 CH2 group which is connected to, and this is also practically not possible, this is also practically not possible, and therefore using these data, and we can, but this carbon is connected to amine, and therefore we can simply connect. And these two is not connected from the value we say, and this is connected, and therefore there is 2 CH2 and 1 CH3, and it is very clear that it is a secondary amine which has symmetrical groups on either side. Let us combine all the data. This is what we confirmed, NH and CH3 twice, and twice is not possible, here also twice, here also twice, and therefore all CH3, CH2, CH2 must come 2 times, and therefore 1 time on this side, 1 time on the other side of the secondary amine, that will be a perfect match, and therefore I propose this structure for the compound. Let us analyze the molecular weight of the compound C6H15N. If you calculate molecular weight, there are 6 carbon, 6 into 12, that is equal to 72, and there are 15 hydrogen and 1 nitrogen. One nitrogen, this is 72 plus 14, that is 86. 86 plus 15, that is 101. It exactly matches with the molecular weight of the compound. Okay, thank you. I think it is clear. We shall meet in another structural elucidation. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank